Well, a literary gold mine, and that's how experts described the hoard of papers discovered in a bank vault. The major find included an original Byron manuscript and possibly unknown poems by Shelley, and the complete hoard could be worth as much as £500,000. With me now is Doris Langley, an expert on Byron.
Doris Langley, it's fascinating that these papers belong to the Reverend Scrope Davis, because he seems to be in a bit of a retrograde. What kind of guy was he?
Well, he was only reverend because dons had to be reverend in those days, but he was very irreverent in private life. He was a very witty, ingenious man, and obviously Byron was very fond of him and tolerated a great deal from him.
He was obviously also a bit of a rogue, wasn't he?
Well, wasn't very honest of him to keep the manuscript of the third canto of Childe Harold, which he was supposed to deliver to the publisher. But in general, you see, he was a very generous man, and he, at his great risk, lent Byron the enormous sum which took him on his first travels.
Mm-hmm. What was Scrope Davis like? Do we know what he's like?
Well, unfortunately, we've no portrait at all of him, and I'm hoping that this discovery and all the publicity that it's having will bring forth some portrait.
So you think there may be a portrait of him, more papers?
There must be, and yes, more papers perhaps, because he's said to have written memoirs. Mm-hmm. And they've never been found, but he fled to the continent to escape from his creditors, and he wrote these memoirs on the continent. I think they're still there somewhere.
What does the finding of an original manuscript of the third canto mean by Byron? I mean, are we likely to find it not the same as the one we know?
Well, I should think the differences won't be enormous, because, it was the fair copy. I don't think it would have enormous, but it has some differences, I understand. I haven't seen it, you see. Mm-hmm. But what is of great interest to me is the unpublished letters of Byron.
And they, of course, are going to be able to be studied, aren't they? What's going to happen to those?
Well, I hope they're going to be published in this series of volumes of Byron's letters, which the sixth generation of Byron's publisher, John Murray, is bringing out, and they're going to be added to an extra volume. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be very interesting. I hope to read them before then, however.
It seems an enormous sum of money, the valuation put on them, £500,000. Can you actually value a find like this?
Well, you see, I don't profess to be expert at all in sums of money like that, but the manuscripts of Beppo fetched £55,000, which was the highest sum ever paid for an English manuscript after the 15th or 16th century.
Mm-hmm. So, do you think they'll be put up for auction?
I hope not, because this would be a great shame. I understand that it's hoped that they'll stay in the British Museum.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.